Hello students, welcome you all to the lecture on the subject Advanced Accounting. Today we'll discuss the topic Company Final Accounts. The final accounts are prepared by every business organization at the end of the year to find out the profitability and to find out the financial position. But the final accounts of sole trading concern and partnership, there is no specific format. We can prepare the final accounts in any form. But regarding joint stock company, a specific format is given by the Companies Act. And every company must follow the prescribed format to prepare the financial statements of joint stock company. Now in this unit, we are going to study how to prepare the financial statements of companies and we'll solve a number of problems on preparation of financial statements of joint stock companies. So we are not going in depth regarding the accounts to be maintained, all the accounts to be maintained by the Companies Act, only regarding financial statements we are going to discuss in this unit. First of all, according to Section 128 of the Companies Act 2013, every company must maintain proper books of account at its registered office regarding all the sum of money received and expended and the matters to which these receipts and expenditure take place. Similarly, proper books of accounts regarding all the purchases and sales, proper books of accounts regarding all the assets and liabilities. And in case of a company pertaining to a specific class of companies engaged in the production, manufacturing or processing or mining activities, the details regarding the utilization of material, labor or other items of cost as may be prescribed. For this purpose, in order to attain this objective, the proper books of accounts must be maintained. The books of accounts like cash book to record all the cash and bank transactions, sales book to record all the credit sales, purchases book to record all the credit purchases. Similarly, sales return book to record all the returns from the customers, purchase returns book to record all the returns to the suppliers. Similarly, bills receivable book to record the details of bills receivable, bills payable book to record the details of bills payable. A journal proper is maintained to record the opening entries, closing entries, adjusting entries, rectification entries. All these entries will make in journal proper. Similarly, a general ledger will be maintained to record all the accounts not relating to customers and suppliers. Similarly, a debtor's ledger is maintained to record the accounts, to maintain the accounts of all customers. Creditor's ledger should be maintained to record all the accounts of suppliers. These are the different books of accounts which are maintained by a joint stock company. Apart from that, the statutory registers should be maintained. The registers are register of members, register of debenture holders, and registers of investments made by the company, minutes book to record all the minutes of general meeting and board of directors meeting, etc. These are the statutory books to be maintained. Now we'll discuss about the final accounts. The annual accounts. The final accounts of a joint stock company consist of basic two financial statements, that is statement of profit and loss and the balance sheet. Section 129 of the Companies Act 2013 says every company should lay the financial statements before the annual general meeting. Every company should prepare and present to the company at every annual general meeting the financial statements. Similarly, this section says every financial statement shall give a true and fair view of the state of affairs of the company. So while preparing the financial statements, one should keep in mind the provisions regarding Schedule 3 of the Companies Act and other statutory requirements. Apart from that, the accounting standards given by the Institute of Chartered Accountants of India and the statements and guidance notes which are given by the ICAI while preparing the financial statements. So the financial statements consist of statement of profit and loss and the balance sheet. So first we discuss about the format revised Schedule 3. Earlier, the old Companies Act 1956 have a different format that was in traditional form, T form. Left hand side, debit side, right hand side, credit side. That T form, traditional form was used. But according to the revised Schedule 3, we have two parts, part 1, part 2. Part 1 is balance sheet and part 2 is statement of profit and loss. It is not an account, it's in a statement form. So the format will be like this. Statement of profit, first of all we should write the name of the company, dash company limited. Statement of profit and loss for the year ending, whatever is the year. Then this is the format of bilkul concise. I have prepared this format in a concise manner. So revenue from operations first we'll take, then other income, the total revenue A. This is the first part. After completing this format, I'll give the complete explanation. What are the items that may come under revenue from operations? What are the items that may come under other income? Like that. We'll discuss more in detail. Right now, just to remember the format of preparing the statement of profit and loss and the balance sheet. So revenue from operations, other income. This is the total revenue A. Then below it, expenses. Expenses will take cost of material consumed. In this cost of material consumed, we have to take the opening stock of material, purchase of material, returns, then closing stock of material. We'll adjust it in the notes. Then employee benefit expenses, finance cost, depreciation, other expenses. So five items normally will come. So five items, the total of these five items are the total of expenses B. From that, profit before tax. A is the revenue and B is the expense. So revenue minus expense will get profit before tax. From this we subtract tax expense, current year's tax expense, deduct, then we'll get profit after tax. Actually, this is only a concise statement of profit and loss. Still a number of other items will come, but for our basic knowledge purpose, this is the format of statement of profit and loss. Then we'll come to the balance sheet. Part 1. Dash Company Limited balance sheet as at. This is the heading of the balance sheet. Then we'll write on particulars, note number, amount. See, we are making this statement of profit and loss and balance sheet in a concise manner. The details should be given in the notes. And the notes are forming part of financial statements. Notes are not just a working note, rough notes. They are the part of financial statements. The details of all these items which we are showing in the format, that will be shown in the note. So here we have opened one column, note number. We'll write the note number and the details will provide in the notes. So here, particulars, note number, amount, equity and liabilities. So first of all, we should write shareholders fund, under shareholders fund, share capital and reserves and surplus. These two items will come under shareholders fund. Next, share application money, pending allotment. We'll discuss more regarding these items. Right now, presently, you just focus what are the items that may come under statement of profit and loss and balance sheet. We'll discuss more of all these items in the notes. So share capital, reserves and surplus, these are the two items will come under shareholders fund. Then share application money, pending allotment. Agar raha to, in every problem, we won't have this one. In some problems, we'll find this item. If it is there, then only we'll write. Otherwise, there is no need of writing. Non-current liabilities. Under non-current liabilities, long-term borrowings, long-term provisions. These two are the items that come under non-current. Then current liabilities are short-term borrowings, trade payables, short-term provisions, other current liabilities. These are the wordings only we have to use in the financial statements. Next, this is the total of the liability side. This is the total of the liabilities, equity and liabilities. Then below it, we'll write on assets. Assets are classified into non-current assets and current assets. Non-current assets consist of fixed assets. Under fixed assets, we'll take tangible, intangible. See here, there is no need to write all the details regarding tangible assets, land, building, plant, machinery, furniture, all these things we should not show in the balance sheet. That will be shown in the notes forming part of financial statements. So two fixed assets, tangible, intangible. Then we have non-current investments. Non-current investments, if it is there, long-term investment, that will take. Then current assets, continuation of this one. Current assets are current investments, inventories, trade receivable, cash and cash equivalent, short-term loans and advances, other current assets. This is the total of the asset side. So if you do not commit any mistake, the total of liabilities and total of assets will be same. This is the total of liabilities and this is the total of assets. So briefly, I'll recall it again, because the problems which we are going to do it on this company final accounts, we have to follow this format. First of all, two parts are there in this statement of profit and loss. First, revenue from operation, other income. This is the total of revenue. Then expenses are cost of material consumed, employee benefit expenses, finance cost, depreciation, other expenses. The total of this is B. So A minus B is the profit before tax, minus tax expense will get profit after tax. This is the format of statement of profit and loss. Now balance sheet. Balance sheet we have to write on equity and liabilities, shareholders fund. So three parts are there on equity and liability. The first part is shareholders fund. Under shareholders fund, two items, share capital and reserves and surplus. Then we have share application money pending allotment. Ye har problem mein nahi rahega, ek do problem mein rahega, raha to lenge, nahi raha to likhne ki bhi zarurat nahi hai. Then we'll take non-current liabilities. Ab ye non-current liabilities mein long-term borrowings, long-term provisions. These are the items which may come under long-term liability. Ab last one, current liability. Ye current liability mein trade payable, short-term borrowings and short-term provisions, other current liabilities. These are the items which come under current liabilities. So we can see three items, shareholders fund, non-current liability, current liability. Then asset side, again we have three items. The first item is non-current assets. Non-current assets are fixed assets. The fixed assets are again classified into tangible and intangible. Then we have non-current investments, if it is there. Then current assets. Under current assets, we'll take current investment, inventories, trade receivable, cash and cash equivalent, short-term loans and advances, and other current assets. So this is the complete format of the statement of profit and loss and the balance sheet. We'll discuss each and every item of all these items which you find in the statement of profit and loss and the balance sheet. So we have discussed up to the preparation, the format of preparing the statement of profit and loss and the format of balance sheet, and what are the items that may come under statement of profit and loss account and profit and loss statement and balance sheet. Now we'll discuss the terms which are used in the financial statements, specific meaning of the terms which are used in the financial statements. So general information and notes of accounts. See, the financial statements are prepared in a concise form. The details should be given in the notes, and notes forms part of financial statements. In a jo bhi notes banayenge wo financial statements ka part rahega. So what are the details we have to provide in the notes? Now we are going to discuss. The first, in the balance sheet, first item will take shareholders fund. Under shareholders fund, we will take share capital and reserves and surplus. These two items will come under shareholders fund. So under share capital, we have to show the authorized capital, this issued capital, subscribed capital, called up capital, paid up capital. The different forms of capital, if information is given in the problem, then we have to specify all different types of capital in the notes. Authorized capital is the maximum capital which a company can raise, the capital which is specified in the memorandum of association, beyond which the capital cannot be procured. Then issued capital is a part of subscribed capital which is issued to the public. And subscribed capital is a part of issued capital which is actually subscribed by the public. Called up capital is the amount which is actually called by the company. And paid up capital is the actual amount paid by the shareholders. All the details. And if there are any calls in arrear, unpaid calls, that should be deducted from the paid up capital. If shares forfeited account is there and it is showing a balance in shares forfeited account, that will be added to paid up capital. The detail regarding share capital should be shown in the notes. Next comes reserves. Reserves and surplus. This is the second item under shareholders fund. Under reserves and surplus, we have to show capital reserve, debenture redemption fund, capital redemption fund, then security premium account or any other reserves. All different types of reserves we have to specify. Surplus, the balance remaining in statement of profit and loss. That balance is called surplus and that should be shown as a part of reserves and surplus. But sometimes this surplus will show a debit balance, will show a loss. Then that loss should be taken as a negative figure. Loss should be taken as a negative figure under reserves and surplus. Then we have share application money pending allotment. Sometimes application money is received from the shareholders, from the public, but the shares are not yet allotted. Till the time shares are not allotted, the money pending, that amount will be kept under share application money pending allotment. Once the share allotment is made, that will become a part of the share capital. So this share application money pending allotment should be written as a separate item between shareholders fund and long-term non-current liabilities. Between non-current liabilities. Next comes current and non-current liability. So according to the new format, in the balance sheet, the current liability and non-current liability should be separately shown. So under non-current liability, we have to show all non-current liability, we have to show long-term borrowings or long-term provisions, etc. And current liabilities are those liabilities which are payable within a period of 1 year, like trade payable, etc. Then long-term borrowings. Long-term borrowings is a part of non-current liability. Non-current liability ka pahla part hai long-term borrowings. Under long-term borrowings will come debentures, bonds or any other long-term deposits, etc. Then long-term provisions. Sometimes the provision will be kept by the company for the benefit of employees. Employee benefit ke liye kuch provision bana ke, jaisa retirement benefit hai, gratuity hai, uske liye koi provision bana kar rakhe, provident fund hai. That provision will be taken under long-term provision. Any other long-term provision to be specified if it is there. Next comes short-term borrowings. Sometimes in the problem, short-term borrowings will be given. These short-term borrowings will be taken under current liabilities. Then loan from banks like bank overdraft. Then other short-term borrowings to be specified. Then comes other current liabilities. Ab current liabilities mein kya kya items aayenge? Trade payable, etc. Trade payable or short-term provisions, short-term borrowings, apart from the other current liabilities. So interest due on bank loan, interest due on debentures, manager's remuneration payable, unpaid dividend, outstanding expenses, outstanding salary, outstanding rent, etc. So any amount which is due within 1 year will come under other current liability. Next, short-term provisions. Under short-term provisions, we have to take provision for taxation and any other short-term provision if there is. Then tangible assets. Now we'll come to asset side. The first item is non-current assets. Under non-current assets will come fixed assets. Under fixed assets, two items will be taken, tangible assets and intangible. So tangible assets are those assets which can be seen, which can be touched, which will have physical existence. Example of tangible assets are land, building, plant and machinery, furniture, vehicle, office equipment. Ye sara detail aapko notes mein batana hai. Aur uska jo total tangible asset aata hai, that total tangible asset will be taken in the balance sheet. So all these detail will not be shown in the balance sheet. The details will be shown in the notes forming part of financial statement. Next comes intangible asset. The asset which cannot be seen, which cannot be touched. Physical existence will not be there, but it is a real asset. It is an asset. Example of intangible assets are goodwill, patent right, copyright, brands or computer software. These are the examples of intangible assets. All the details should be shown in notes and the total will be taken in the balance sheet. Next come non-current investments. In some problems, non-current investments are given. That means investments are made by the company for long-term purpose, not for current within 1 year, it cannot be converted into cash. For long-term purpose, the company has made the investment. Example, investment in equity instruments or preferences, debentures, bonds or mutual funds. These are called non-current investments. Next comes long-term loans and advances. In some problems we'll come across security deposit, loans and advances to related parties. Then cash and cash equivalent. This is a part of current asset. Current asset. Every problem will have current assets. Under current assets, one of the items is cash and cash equivalent. Cash and cash equivalent. The difference is cash means the cash on hand. Cash equivalent means the amount which is lying in the bank or checks or drafts which can easily be converted into cash. So examples are balances with banks, checks and drafts on demand, and cash in hand. These three items will come under cash and cash equivalent. Next comes revenue from operation. This is the first item in statement of profit and loss. Profit and loss statement mein pahla item revenue from operations. The revenue which is generated from the operating activity of the business. Basic operating activity of the business. Example are sale of products, sale of services, any other operating revenue minus excise duty. Agar excise duty ho to minus kar denge. So this is the revenue from operation. Next comes other incomes. The second item under revenue. Revenue mein do hi item hai, ek revenue from operations, ek other income. Ab other income mein koi bhi income jo operating income nahi hai. Example hai interest income, dividend income or gain or loss on sale of investment. So these are some of the basic terms which are used in the financial statements. So students, some more items are there which are part of financial statements. These items are changes in inventories of finished goods and work in progress. Sometimes in the problem, the opening and closing stock, stock of finished goods, stock of work in progress are given. In that case, we have to compare the opening stock with the closing stock. We have to take the total of these two. Which are the two one? First one, stock of finished goods, stock of work in progress. Ye dono ka add kar lenge. Opening ka bhi add karenge, closing ka bhi add karenge. Ab dono ko compare karenge. Opening stock and closing stock. If closing stock total is more than opening stock, take it as a negative figure. If the closing stock is more than opening stock, the difference will be taken as a negative figure in the statement of profit and loss. Haan, agar closing stock kam hai, if the total closing stock is less than opening stock, then whatever difference is there, the difference will be taken as positive. So we have to compare the opening stock with the closing stock. Stock of finished goods, stock of WIP. Right? In some problems, it will be given changes in inventories of finished goods and work in progress. Then we have finance cost. This is also one of the items under expenses in statement of profit and loss. In finance cost, interest charges will be taken. Interest on loan, interest on debenture, etc. So other borrowing cost. Then employee benefit expense. This is also one of the item of expense in statement of profit and loss. In this item, we'll take all salaries, wages, medical expenses, and contribution to provident fund or any other fund relating to employees. So any payment made directly or indirectly to employees will be taken under employee benefit expense. Last item of expenses are other expenses. In other expenses, we take all expenses which are not taken as a cost of material consumed, employee benefit expense or finance cost or depreciation. 5 items hai. वो 5 items में से जो भी पहले 4 item में नहीं आएगा उसको डाल देंगे other expenses. तो example of other expenses are consumption of stores and spare parts, power and fuel, rent, repairs to building, maintenance, machinery, insurance, rates and taxes, miscellaneous expense. In simple words, all expenses will be taken under other expenses which are not fit under first 4 categories. Then we have preliminary expenses. One of the important expenses in a company is preliminary expenses. The expenses incurred prior to the incorporation of the company are called preliminary expenses. Now, according to the old schedule, old Companies Act 1956, the amount not written off, the preliminary expenses not written off should be shown on the asset side of the balance sheet under miscellaneous expenditure. तो preliminary expenses को पुराने companies act के हिसाब से balance sheet में asset side पे show करते थे under miscellaneous expenditure. But in the new format, there is no miscellaneous expenditure on the asset side of the balance sheet. So how it should be done? No specific provision is given in the Companies Act. The normal procedure is the amount not written off, the preliminary expenses which are not written off should be taken under reserves and surplus. It can be deducted from reserves, from surplus. It can be deducted from surplus or it can be shown as a negative item under reserves and surplus. This is the treatment for preliminary expenses. Next comes discount on issue of shares and debentures. Sometimes the company will issue the shares at a discount or the company will issue debentures at a discount. This discount is a capital loss. This capital loss will be written off over a period of time. So over a period of time, so jab tak ki wo write off nahi hua, tab tak usko asset side ke upar miscellaneous expenditure mein show karte the according to old Companies Act. But we don't have miscellaneous expenditure. We are not going to show it on the asset side. So what is our treatment then? Instructions will be given in the problem. We will follow the instructions. If no instructions are given, normally this discount on the issue of debentures or shares should be deducted from the reserves under reserves and surplus. The last item is dividend distribution tax, DDT. The system of dividend distribution tax was applied from the Finance Act 1997. The rate of DDT, dividend distribution tax, will be decided by the Finance Act every year. So presently it is 15%. So DDT kab lagega? When the company pays the dividend. Jab company declare kar di dividend, to dividend ko declare karne ke time pe DDT will be paid by the company. So 15% exclusive of surcharge and education cess. 12% is surcharge and 3% is education cess. So cumulatively, DDT comes to 17.304%. 17.304%. 15% is the actual tax. Then 12% is surcharge. So we calculate 12% of 15. Add up. Then the total, jo bhi total aayega, that is DDT plus surcharge. Wo total ke upar 3% education cess add kar denge. So total tax, total DDT amount will be 17.304%. But remember, this DDT will be applied only when the company declares the dividend. So these are some of the concepts we have discussed. After listening this lecture, you will not feel much difficulty while solving the problem on financial statements. That is statement of profit and loss and the balance sheet. In the next session, we'll start the problems on company final accounts.